Good afternoon, everyone. Welcome to part two of our live Essbase webinar series focused on what it will take to migrate your Essbase applications to Oracle Enterprise Performance Management Cloud Enterprise and determine the approach that best fits your profile. Today's presenters are Mike Killeen, Senior Vice President of Technology at Alithya, and Mija Deering, Principal Solutions Director at Alithya. Attendees are welcome to submit questions in the chat, and we'll try to make time near the end of today's presentation to address them. So with that, let's give a warm welcome to our experts and kick off today's presentation.
Thank you, Mary. Good day, everybody, and welcome to session number two, talking about migrating Essbase applications to the cloud. As Mary alluded to, the first session was really focused more on a lift and shift approach, which we typically find geared towards more reporting-centric solution. Today's session is going to be more about a transformative approach and specifically how some of the Oracle EPM cloud packaged applications can help simplify processes, add capability, as well as provide system and performance benefits as we get to that a little bit later on. Quickly for our agenda today, we'll do a brief welcome and introduction. We will spend some time providing an overview of some of our poll results from the last session. We asked many of you who have participated for some data points about your environments, which for us helped to establish the customer profile and identify the appropriate approach to move forward. And then we'll kind of close out with some use cases for transformation migrations and then wrap up. Next slide, please. So first, very quickly, in terms of introductions, my name is Mike Killeen. I'm a Senior Vice President for Alithya. Alithya is an Oracle consulting partner. We're specifically focused on Oracle cloud applications and technology. But as you can see from some of the photos there, both Mija and myself have been working in this space dating back to the Arthur Essbase days. Little photo here and now. I currently lead our solutions team, but at about 20 years of delivery experience, both hands-on implementations as well as running a practice. Again, my primary role is helping our clients really figure out how to maximize their investments in the Oracle Cloud applications and technology and help support some of the road mapping processes associated with getting there. Mija, do you want to do a quick intro?
Sure. Good afternoon. My name is Mija Deering. I'm a Principal Solutions Director, and like Mike, been around the EPM space for 20 plus years as an implementation consultant as well as trainer, but just excited about the Oracle EPM cloud environment and capabilities. So nice to be here today on today's call.
Yeah, and I think one of the key takeaways for the folks on the call, particularly if you're living in an on-premise Essbase world, as implementers, as consultants, we went through this itself. I started my career building custom solutions through Visual Basic and Excel VBA using the Essbase APIs, and have had to kind of go through the evolution from Essbase through Hyperion, now into EPM cloud. And while initially it was a bit different and it was challenging, we were able to get there. And so, again, I hope for both Mija and myself, some of our own personal experiences as well as that of our clients will help encourage you on these journeys as well and give you some data points to help make informed decisions. Let's go to the next slide. So we did want to recap some of our poll results. I think we have about 31 people across maybe 15 organizations registered for this call. Some of the results to me were not that surprising. I think a lot of long-term Essbase customers, one of the prevalent features is they have a large number of cubes. So over 55% or half of you had greater than 20 in their environment. What's interesting is there's not a lot of new cube creation, but the guess is that the new cubes created each year are predominantly for archiving purposes. And so that whole grab a snapshot at the end of the fiscal year or calendar year is pretty typical. What's not surprising also is that there are a variety of use cases for Essbase. Mija talked about last time Essbase being the ultimate Swiss Army knife. And so seeing customers using it not only for reporting, but for planning and profitability solutions is not that atypical. What's also not surprising is that the Excel add-in, now moved on to SmartView, is the predominant tool of choice, that self-service capability Again, very typical of Essbase shops, although there is a proliferation of some BI, as well as some third-party applications. What's interesting is some of the legacy Hyperion BI tools, such as Web Analysis and Brio, were not called out, and it's good to see people have migrated off of that. Then finally, from an integration standpoint, historically, load rule single interface were the predominant data integration mechanism for Essbase, but you do see a smattering of other tools in there as well. Next slide. Additionally, in terms of our peers, I think these two go together. Over half of our respondents are managing their Essbase environments today through an IT application development team. And that probably is consistent with the fact that over half of our respondents are also supporting Essbase with some form of uniform master data tool. If you're working in an environment with over 20 cubes and you're trying to create synchronization and consistency, that's just a good leading practice along those lines. And then finally, the last item in terms of other applications, only about 1 in 5 are using something other than Essbase in their shop in terms of the packaged application. So again, it kind of lends itself to the purpose of this conversation is really about those custom built business applications that have been configured in Essbase, whether it be with custom front ends or heavy calc scripts, maybe fronted by SmartView and other bulk upload mechanisms. What are some of the benefits of the additional modules of Oracle EPM Cloud going to help, both from a business perspective as well as from a system standpoint? And what are some of the transformational aspects of that? And so with that, I'm going to pass it over to Misha, and she's going to spend a little time talking about that evolution from lift and shift into transform. So Misha, over to you.
Thank you, Mike. So as a consultancy, one of the questions that we're often asked by customers is, what is the recommended migration path for our on-premise Essbase applications? And typically, like any consultancy, our answer is it depends. And it really depends on two things primarily for us is really the customer attribute profile, which I'll talk about in a second, as well as the current Essbase use cases. So how are you using it today in your on-premise footprint? As we discovered last time and with some of the poll results now, we've seen a wide range of use cases for Essbase and some very common things that we've seen across many organizations. So it really just depends on those two key attributes in terms of the migration approach. So do we do a lift and shift? Do we do a transformative approach, or do we do a hybrid? Part one session was really talking about that lift and shift approach, and today we're going to talk about some of the use cases for the more transformative approach. So when I answered about the it depends on, what are the key factors in making a recommendation for migration paths. These are some of the areas that we look into assessing for our customer attributes, and these are some of the key considerations. As we called out with many organizations, we do see a lot of customers who have a large number of cubes, as we saw 55% with more than 20 cubes. And also looking into the frequency of those applications, and are those new applications really created for archive purposes or really new business needs? And what are the types of applications and the complexity around those processes? Like to look at the user and organization profile. So as your organization, really taking the motto of don't fix it if it's not broken, or are you an organization, a user group that is always seeking new ways to innovate and be transformative? So what is your profile in regards to change? Looking at reporting requirements, as we saw, a lot of customers are predominantly still using SmartView and the Excel components, and it's clear that we're never going to get away from that. But we do see also a need and for those formatted standard reports and books. And interesting, with the cloud, they have some additional capabilities around the visualizations and dashboards, as well as the collaborative and narrative reporting. And then just some other key considerations, again, who's owning and maintaining the applications for you? How are those integrations being performed? What are the upstream, downstream systems? Are there a need to potentially move from intra-cloud applications? And how are you managing the metadata? So these are some of the key considerations when making a recommendation to migrate to the cloud. In addition, we like to look at the use cases. So how are you using the Essbase cubes today in here? So if I look at an Essbase use case for planning and budgeting, and first taking a look at the on-premise, we can see if I've got my standalone Essbase application or applications. I would be using traditionally the Excel and SmartView for reporting. And for terms of the content, I may have a lot of offline Excel-based models to do some of that business planning activities and modeling. I may have other legacy operational planning systems in there to feed some of that. And then sending that input into the Essbase application for consolidation, and then perhaps applying some calculations to do some consolidation or some additional business logic. So if you're looking to migrate to the cloud, you can certainly take a lift and shift approach. And that might be in this case to EPM Freeform. In which case you all of a sudden can see that you've got some additional capabilities and benefits of taking that migration approach. First of all, you've got now web-based dashboards, which are included in the free form. You've got the ability to access formatted reports via the web. You've got access to narrative reporting or collaborative reporting, and also the ability to incorporate data integrations, task lists, and web forms into part of your footprint. Again, taking advantage of some new feature functionality, but in this case, a lot of the core modeling and business requirements might still be done in other legacy operational tools, might still be done in some of those Excel-based models. So you really haven't incorporated some of that new feature functionality. You really have enhanced some of the processes around gathering that data, but not necessarily the core business. So in this case, you know, for customers who are using Essbase for planning and budgeting, I think we would generally recommend using a more transformative approach using EPM planning. And in this context, again, you've got access to all those additional reporting capabilities. But if I look at the box itself, as a customer, you now have access to pre-built configurable processes. So that could streamline your migration to the cloud. You also have the optional component to build your own custom model. So if you've got very specific type modeling that you're doing, you can certainly leverage that capability as well. But not only do you have that, you've also got the ability to leverage LRP for strategic modeling in here, which is included as part of your subscription. You can leverage predictive planning, which is some of the new emerging practices we're seeing in a lot of organizations, as well as the intelligence performance management and insights. And you can also leverage the workflow approvals, data integrations, and task management. So you can see clearly that there's a lot more ability to transform what you're currently doing from an on-premise standpoint as you migrate to the cloud. So again, the use case for budgeting, forecasting, if you're doing an AOP, budgeting, forecast, or long-range plan, is to most likely do a transformative approach. And why? Because we've got built-in accelerators with configurable planning and forecasting processes already incorporated into the solution. And it's around those processes, very typical in our solutions, and customers needing capabilities around revenue or expense planning, around balance sheet cash flow, workforce, capital, project, as well as custom. And then also the ability to incorporate, again, included in the solution is the ability to marry the LRP and strategic planning processes. So again, pre-built process-centric training methodologies, calculations, and rules, so you don't have to do them in offline models or calc scripts. You've got pre-built dimensions and members, folders, and dashboards so that you can enable immediately as you enable the application. And then it also includes configurable capabilities around those long-range planning scenarios, strategic modeling. So like if you have to do goal seeking or a target setting or debt restructuring or M&A activities, having that access to that capabilities instead of building it into offline or Excel-based models is huge for many customers. And then just really introducing emergency practices around predictive planning and intelligent performance management. On a side note is really the ability to leverage EPM cloud functionality that really comes out of the box. For example, the ability to incorporate textual commentary and visualizations. Couldn't do that with Essbase applications that was done in Excel or manually in reports. Now you can embed them into the application and software. Leveraging out of the box capabilities like breakback when users are inputting in their budgets and forecasts, the ability to view and track change history, ability to add supporting details, task manager, task list in here, workflow and approvals, or parameterized business roles. And really also to enhance the user experience and performance that you can also gain through the ability to introduce groovy roles. And more importantly is the ability to leverage that common reporting dashboarding capabilities, as well as data integration across the entire EPM suite. So again, use case for budgeting forecasting definitely would probably suggest a transformative approach to move your Essbase applications to the cloud. So just a quick glimpse in here, again, talked about those pre-built business processes around those core areas in here, the ability to leverage dashboards and infolets in the solution, the ability to incorporate reports, the business roles that are performing some of that business logic in the solution, approvals, workflow, and then the intelligent performance management capabilities. So again, with the solution going to the cloud, you've got the ability to use common best practices around trending, seasonality with some of the pre-built forms and dashboards and input forms. You've got pre-built processes around some of those kind of non-financial areas, maybe related to workforce planning. You've got actions in here that are already configured to do things like change existing details for employees, or change transfers in and out. You can manage capital processes in here to support some of that. And then again, some of that long range planning, scenario modeling, target seeking in here. As well as the dashboards, the reporting, the standard reporting, and ability to incorporate notes and commentary, and then the collaborative narrative reporting, which is huge for many customers. Every customer has to put together at some point some type of budget book or monthly executive package that incorporates contextual context and narrative, as well as numerical values and tables and charts that may be coming from your EPM platform. So having this capability is a huge advantage and benefit for many customers. If I look at the use case, we saw that
I can just add one more comment real quick. So if I'm going to summarize before moving to the next use case around planning and budgeting, historically we find for many of our on-premise planning and budgeting customers using Essbase, it's very numbers focused, it's very financial focused, and it's very Excel focused, and may involve a lot of additional processes after the Excel report to get the NATE information out. And may involve a lot of offline models and other planning tools as precursors to get the information in. In a transformative approach, the new capabilities of EPM Cloud that include visualizations, workflow, as well as enhanced modeling. And in addition to that, the ability to support data types that are not just numerical, being able to capture text, dates, smart lists, all those forms of things, really allow the EPM Cloud solution to move past just it's about the numbers and finance only, to becoming a little bit more operationally integrated, which adds that aspect. So that's really one of the kind of key takeaways as we think about the difference between, you know, a lift and shift as opposed to transform. So Samisha, I'll pass it back to you.
Great. Thanks, Mike. The other use case that we saw based on our poll results is that a lot of customers are using Essbase to perform management type allocations, whether it be expense or IT costing, shared services, or even trying to achieve customer product profitability. And in this case, this is a good example where we would recommend transforming your Essbase applications to enterprise PCM, or profitability and cost management. And the reason for that is really leveraging the cloud-based solution will empower business users to take ownership of building their own models, their own allocation rules and rule sets. So it is a business user-driven functionality that they can leverage a lot of the pre-built, commonly used driver-based allocation methodologies. They can leverage the pre-built capabilities that support what-if analysis on the models themselves and not just the numbers to create for some different scenario and what if versions, as well as managing points of views. So that if they wanted to do that what ifing, the business user has the ability to copy those drivers, copy the data between rules and rule sets and across different scenarios and versions. And because of that, The solution really fosters a culture of accountability so that you can see what are those allocations, those costs that I'm now incurring, and where are they coming from. So there's transparency, and there's also built-in mechanisms for traceability. So there is also within the solution embedded intelligence. And again, these are all things that weren't readily available in the traditional standalone Essbase Cube. These are all things that are available with the pre-built functionality available with the Oracle EPM Cloud. So EPM embedded intelligence, what that offers is really the built-in intelligence to design those rules so that you can highlight the ins and outs as part of your allocations processes. And they would be visible on some of the out-of-the-box reports, like the balancing report. You could also see some of the embedded intelligence available on the trace screen, so you can see where those allocations are coming from and where they're going to, as well as maybe some other visualizations to show true profitability on some of those visualizations. So again, just leveraging some of the common reporting and dashboard capabilities that we just talked about from the Oracle EPM planning side, as well as some of those basic cloud functionalities, such as the visualizations, the ability to incorporate text and commentary into that solution. So for this case, you know, for management allocations, our recommendation would be to use a transformative approach to leverage some of these capabilities that we just described. So in terms of some of the key benefits, we talk about it with our acronym FAST, which really provides users with flexibility, accuracy, a shared methodology, as well as transparency in here. So I'm not going to read all the bullet points today, but this is just in terms of some of the key benefits that the solution provides for you. And just in terms of looking at the solution itself, got some screenshots. So this is a screenshot that shows you how a business user can do the assignments of the source for their allocations and then the target, and really go through a kind of wizard to define those roles, the allocation roles. And then the business user also has the ability to define the rule sets within the models. And then again, some of that embedded intelligence, those pre-built and out-of-the-box reports. So this is an example of a balancing report that will show you the allocations in and the allocations out and at the various stages of those allocations. Some of the visualizations that will show you how you can trace and see some of that transparency across your allocation processes, so I can drill in to hone in to see where that's coming from. And then also some of that reporting capabilities within the solution and other visualizations that are available to you. So again, these are all things that you could not have achieved using just pure standalone Essbase to perform some of those allocations in an on-premise environment. The last use case that we're going to cover today is really we see customers, not as many on the poll results, but we do know customers have used Essbase to perform financial consolidations and here to during the monthly close. Or for eliminations in here. And really, again, this is a use case where we would recommend the transformative approach to migrate to the cloud using Oracle's financial consolidation and close. And why we would recommend that is really because, again, leveraging pre-built functionality that supports a lot of common consolidation processes. If you need to do FX currency translations in here, it's got built-in capabilities around that. Intercompany eliminations, again, out-of-the-box capabilities to support those intercompany elims, as well as out-of-the-box calculations that will support your currency translation adjustments, common if you're doing FX currency, roll forwards, and opening balances, overrides, either rate or amount-based, the ability to flow through your net income to retained earnings, doing some of the balance sheet, as well as simplifying some of the cash flow and automating some of that process. It also has out-of-the-box capabilities if you're an organization that has requirements around minority or controlling interests in there, or if you need to do journals, top sides, as well as the capabilities around enterprise journals. So if you need to push that back to your source systems, as well as drill back capabilities to source. And then again, some of the other common things we see in a closed process that you weren't necessarily able to leverage using standalone Essbase is Task Manager, or the ability to upload supplemental data as part of your closed process, as well as the text and commentary that we talked about. And then it also supports external reporting. So these are a highlight of some of the key features. Again, why we would recommend a transformative approach to migrate your Essbase applications if you're using them for consolidation purposes to the cloud. And again, common theme throughout some of the use cases is leveraging the same reporting and dashboard capabilities, the same data integration capabilities, as well as the ability to capture the visualizations and text and commentary, which is so important from what we've heard from many organizations. So again, just to show you in terms of the capabilities and screen within the application, you've got the ability to access your consolidation. It's where you input your assumptions around the minority and controlling interests, task manager to help facilitate those closed task schedules that you might need to incorporate as part of your closed process. Supplemental data, again, if you needed to upload any PPE schedules or headcount or other information as part of your close, the enterprise journals, so forth. So within one solution, you can manage and perform all of these tasks. So again, Consolidation Flows offers some of that pre-built functionality, and it's leveraging some of the pre-built dimensionality that comes with the solution, and then you can add your own custom dimensions. This is the screen that shows the where a business user or administrator can enter the minority interest percentages or controlling interest percentages in here. This is where a user can enter the top size or journal entries within the solution. And then the close manager task schedule in here, which can incorporate not only close related tasks, but also budget and planning related tasks. And then there's some out of the box dashboards that are available to show you some of the process where you are in the closed cycle in terms of prioritization of the task. But you can also, there's also visualizations that will show you based upon the individual to see who is performing their task on time, who is habitually late, so that you can, as an organization, kind of address some of those things. So again, out of the box dashboards that are available to you. So why?
Misha, just as a quick comment on that. And I think in terms of these use cases, you know, custom budgeting and forecasting, custom profitability and custom consolidation, you know, the most typical two are the first two. We've only had a couple of customers who've attempted to build custom consolidation solutions in Essbase. Typically, the migration path to the closed suite or FCCS is more of an HFM view. But, you know, particularly in some of our financial services clients, we have seen that. And so, again, we did want to make sure we were articulating that capability as well as we went through this process. So back to you, Misha.
So I think in terms of, like, you know, why take a transformative approach with Oracle EPM Enterprise Cloud? And I just kind of highlighted some of the key bullet points in here, really is to empower business users with accessing and being able to manage and maintain applications in here. There's no code in terms of being able to create forms and being able to manage hierarchies. So it really empowers the business users to kind of manage the business a little bit. Key is leveraging the pre-built configurable processes. So that will streamline your deployment to the cloud and migration to the cloud, but it also incorporates a lot of the best practices that we see in a lot of organizations and industries. But more importantly, with transformative approach, you can really enhance what you're doing today. So not only with the additional reporting capabilities that you get within the cloud, but also in just in terms of the built-in processes and functionality that Oracle has provided. You can also streamline and centralize. So within the solution, as you saw on one of the earlier charts, you can see that you can actually do more within the solution and kind of eliminate or reduce the amount of things that you're doing offline or in other external models and processes in here. So really to be able to put more of that into the cloud. Stay current. Right, as Oracle, as with the cloud solution, Oracle is continuously providing innovation and new feature functionality. So as an organization, you don't have to wait for certain periods to do an upgrade or apply patches. Really, Oracle provides you that on a monthly and quarterly basis with new features and functionality. And then also be able to extend beyond finance. So you can include activities such as workforce, capital, project planning into the solution. So those users, again, might be outside of finance. Maybe also incorporate treasury activities through the use of the strategic modeling capabilities. So these are some of the key reasons, I think, in terms of why take a transformative approach to migrating to the cloud. So with that, we have a call to action. And Mike?
Great. Thank you, Misha. So hopefully through these two sessions, we've understood some of the key factors that dictate our customer profiles, as well as some of the typical deployment paths that customers can take to get from ground to cloud, whether it be lift and shift, hybrid, or transform, as well as some of the types of use cases that transformative approaches. The reality is, because every customer really fits the "it depends" profile, one of the things that Alithya has done is put together a quick hit ground to cloud assessment or roadmap that helps to provide for your organization an understanding of what the ideal path for you to get to cloud would be, in addition to understanding and learning more about Oracle cloud capabilities and features. This can be utilized whether you are considering lift and shift or transform. So if there is any interest in this, you certainly can reach us at info@alithyasolutions.com. And something that we've done for numerous customers who've begun their cloud journey. Next slide. I did want to take a moment and thank you for your time. Again, we've covered a lot of material in two 30-minute sessions. There's certainly much more that's out there. You can find additional resources on our Alithya website. And Oracle themselves has got a number of educational resources delivered through YouTube, as well as EPM Cloud that can highlight specific features and functionality. On behalf of Misha Deering and myself, I want to thank you for your time today and turn it back to Mary to wrap up.
Thank you, Mike. Well, we hope everyone gained insight from this webinar, and please visit our website and follow us on LinkedIn to get alerts about our upcoming webinars, events, and more. Thank you to all of our attendees for joining us today, and thank you to Mike and Misha for hosting today's presentation. This concludes today's webinar.